Gran Canaria is a beautiful island in the Canary Islands archipelago. In the first part, we visited the lowlands of Gran Canaria near the sea, and in this second part, we'll go up into the mountains where we experienced three beautiful sunsets at three different locations. So, we have now arrived at Roque Nublo, I think it's called. And you can see it here in the background. It is the most iconic rock formation in Gran Canaria. It is just huge. Like, you can't really see it. That's the problem with shooting with wide angle. But this rock from around here to the top is 90 meters. Absolutely huge. I'm going to photograph it, obviously. Sunset is approaching very, very fast. And I've already put up a time lapse. Hopefully we can see how the trees will get dark first and then all the way up to Roque Nublo, and that should be lit in the very end. Sadly, there are absolutely no clouds whatsoever in the sky, so yeah, I'll have to do without. So to get here is super, super simple. You just park at the official parking lot. You hike all the way up along the official trail, no problem there. About 600-700 meters up, the trail forks into two. There's a sign where you just walk right and down through a forest and then all the way to here. So you come out around here and then you just walk all the way to the end of this plateau. So my plan right now is basically just to work my way from up here where I'm standing. There's a lot of very beautiful compositions. We scouted it yesterday just to be sure that we got it right. And then I will just work my way from up here and then all the way down here a little bit closer. So very simple, and hopefully nothing can go wrong. So while we are waiting for the sun to set, just looking around and shooting whatever I can see, and you can see down here in the background, it just looks so, so beautiful. Absolutely spectacular. So just trying a few different things with polarizer, without polarizer. Right now, I'm not too fond of the polarizer as I'm shooting wide angle. And it only darkens like a part of the sky, and it just looks weird. So I've just put the polarizer away as it doesn't really make sense to photograph with it. So right now, because usually I often photograph landscapes with a lot of movement, but right now there's no movement. So I'm actually shooting in the pixel shift mode as to get it super, super sharp. So I'm quite curious to see how that will turn out when I put it together in Photoshop. Or, well, it's not Photoshop, it's Sony's own editing software.
My biggest struggle on this entire trip was how fast the sunsets happened. Within only a few minutes, the colors changed drastically, and then suddenly the sun is set. I managed to get another composition among the trees which I had planned the day before.
So wow, these sunsets are just so, so fast. It's like 1 minute and boom, it's down. And yeah, it looked beautiful, but I have to work so, so fast. I think I got a couple of photos I'm satisfied with. But yeah, there were no clouds in the sky, so right now I haven't decided yet if I'm going to composite in some clouds. If I do, you'll probably notice. But yeah, so now it is basically blue hour and I'll get ready for some Milky Way photography.
I skipped the composite part as I didn't really have any clouds that fitted, and with the foreground pine trees with their long needles, it's next to nearly impossible to make a seamless composite. The pixel shifted images didn't make a whole lot of difference either, and in the end I preferred the compositions I didn't pixel shift. So much for that feature. I ended up preferring these photos from the shoot. Despite the lack of clouds in the sky, they did turn out quite good. The only small concern I have is the size of Roque Nublo doesn't really come through with these wide angle photos. I mentioned briefly I do some Milky Way photography. I'll show more about that in a future video. The next location is the only location I improvised for sunset. It's technically several stops along the road GC15. From here there is a beautiful view over the valley and different options for foregrounds and focal points.
So right now we are on a scenic drive from a little town further down the valley and then all the way up to the top of the mountain. And right now I'm just using the long lens to photograph Rock Bentayga, I think it's pronounced. And we have like the most beautiful mist and haze down in the valley. So it becomes a very abstract image. Like, it's completely impossible to photograph this with a wide angle. It's the area simply is just too big. So the long lens and just zooming in, and I'm trying to find some aesthetic shapes and curves I can use and make almost like an abstract image. And all that haze just creates so much separation between all the layers all through the image. So you actually get a long lens photo with a really, really great depth.
I was really drawn to these shapes, the light and the haze, but I gotta admit this kind of almost abstract photography is rarely what I do, and it's basically because I don't really feel for it. Despite the lovely conditions, warm summer atmosphere and many layers, they lack a sense of grandeur and depth. We continued up the road to another small location I had spotted on the way down.
So we've now come a little bit further up, and I found a nice little place here where we have some trees in the foreground and then the big rock there in the background, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. Again, I'm shooting with a long lens and I'm using the trees in the foreground to create a little bit more depth. There's quite a lot of separation in this shot already, but I think it looks pretty good with the trees both in the foreground and also as to like frame the lower part of the photo. So all in all, absolutely gorgeous up here. As you can see here, I'm also shooting with my lens hood. And obviously when the sun is so low and it comes directly in and hit the front element, it flares quite a lot. So obviously you would want to make sure that that doesn't happen.
Now this photo here is much more to my liking, a clearly defined focal point with a foreground to frame the bottom of the photo. The trees are beautifully backlit and it keeps the warm summer atmosphere from the setting sun's light. Despite the rock in the background being smaller than in the previous photo, I think there is a better sense of grandeur and scale in this photo. There were one more stop I had spotted, which I think could work, so we jumped in the car and moved on. What attracted me to this place was the small ridge in the foreground where I could place Sophie. Not necessarily for scale, but simply to have the human element in the photo. The sun came down fast and within 30 seconds the colors changed into the most beautiful range of yellows, oranges, reds, purples and blues.
So it's almost sunset and it just happens so fast when you're this far south, like up in the Faroes or in Iceland, it's just the longest sunsets in the world, but here it's just like poof, straight down night. But I've got this beautiful view where you can like see the top of Tenerife in the background, And then I have Sophie in the immediate foreground, and then we just have like the most beautiful sunbeam and colors all through the scene, and it just looks absolutely stunning.
These photos here are definitely some of, if not my favorite photos from Gran Canaria. The colors, the atmosphere, the light, the framing, the depth, the moment and the sense of originality as I haven't seen photos from here before. Everything just came together to make some photos I really, really like. The mountain roads in Gran Canaria are all very zigzaggy. Driving in the mountains, you'll probably stay in second and third gear all the way. Driving from a city like Maspalomas to the mountain areas in the middle of the island takes about an hour and 15 minutes. Dependent on your goal for the trip, you'll have to make a choice whether you want to stay in the tourist areas along the coast or want a bed and breakfast location in the mountains. We stayed in Maspalomas, but in hindsight it would probably have been more efficient to have accommodation in the mountain area and then make day excursions to the beach. And on that note, a rental car comes highly recommended. Also, rentals here are way cheaper than compared to where I normally travel, such as the Faroe Islands.
So we are now at Pico de Las Navias something and I'm going to photograph a beautiful arch and have Roque Nublo in the background. It's a little bit hazy out there, so it's definitely going to be quite the minimalistic photo.
To find the arch, which I'm not sure even has a name, just follow the trail around the mountain. Be careful of the dry gravel as you can easily slip. This is not a place to go in flip-flops. Along the trail you'll pass another characteristic shaped rock. Getting to the right perspective to photograph the arch requires a little climbing, but nothing most people can't do. We shared the plateau with one other photographer and a small group of tourists. I tried to incorporate some foregrounds, but I preferred the photos where the arch were in the foreground and Roque Nublo in the background. As an example, you can play around with putting Roque Nublo in the arch or photograph the sun through the arch. Just like the other two sunsets I showed in this video, the sun came down really fast, so our time to play around were very limited. To me, it is an obvious long lens location. Wide angle photography is not really an option here either, as there's a big gorge between you and the arch. Using the wide angle, you'll just end up with a very small arch.
So that was quite hectic. The sun just comes down so fast, and when you don't exactly know the different positions and the exact angle where the sun sets, you kind of just like improvise. I'm pretty confident I got a few good photos. They are quite minimalistic, but I think it's something I can present to you. So this was the last part of the highlands of Gran Canaria, and what an absolutely beautiful, beautiful island. It's just you know, that warm summer atmosphere and the orange and brown and reddish and yellow mountains, and then it's just like full of green pine trees, and then the setting sun that throws its beams into the valleys and shadows from the different mountains and cliffs, and it's just absolutely stunning. So yeah, here are the pictures.
For what this location had to offer and the fairly unimpressive sunset, I kinda like what I came away with. I usually prefer to photograph into the sun, but in this particular case I actually think the scene would benefit a great deal more from the sidelight you get during the time around winter solstice. If you Google Arch, Gran Canaria and sunset, there are some photos that are much more interesting than mine. On this tour we had 6 days for photography and we used all 6 sunsets. I showed 3 in the first video and 3 in this one. As I mentioned in the beginning, my biggest struggle was by far how fast the sunset happened. I think it's a good idea to prepare from home and have a goal with what you want to photograph, but at the same time be open to improvise. After all, it was when I improvised I got my best photos. We explored way more of the island, and here are a few more photos of what I clicked along the way that I haven't shown yet. If you're on your way to Gran Canaria, be sure to get my digital map down in the description. Here I've added all the different locations we visited throughout the week. I've added the photos for inspiration, and the map is easily integrated with Google Maps. So that was it for my tour to Gran Canaria. If you enjoyed these videos, I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment.